वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू सेंट एंजेल्स पब्लिक स्कूल बागपत ऑनलाइन इकोनॉमिक्स क्लासेस। एज यू नो दैट वी आर वर्किंग फ्रॉम अवर होम, सो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अगेन चैप्टर नंबर 2, 5-year प्लान इन इंडिया, वी कैन से इट्स गोल्स एंड अचीवमेंट्स। सी नाउ टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस फीचर्स ऑफ इकोनॉमिक पॉलिसी, फीचर्स ऑफ इकोनॉमिक पॉलिसी परस्यूड अंडर प्लानिंग, pursued under planning till 1991. It means that we are going to discuss features of economic policy, features of economic policy under, you can say pursued under economic planning. So always remember, means economic policy is different from economic planning, or you can say economic policy is a part of economic planning, but means in today topic is what are the features of economic policy pursued under planning till 1991, or you can say like what are the features of economic policy till 1991. See, first feature, heavy reliance on public sector. Reliance means dependency. So heavy dependency on public sector. See, although Indian economy is a mixed economy, you know that Indian economy is a mixed economy, but in 1991 greater importance was given to public sector. Greater importance was given to public sector. Listen carefully, we know that Indian economy is a mixed economy, but in 1991 greater importance was given to public sector, you can say government sector. See, what do you mean by mixed economy? Mixed economy is an economy in which both private sector as well as public sector, play important role in economic activities. See, now, but in 1991 greater importance was given to public sector than private sector, example in industrial policy 1956, always remember, means industrial policy according to industrial policy 1956, 17 industries were reserved for public sector. 17 industries were reserved for public sector and 12 industries reserved for private sector. So I hope all of you have understood, means how will you explain this point? First of all, you will write Indian economy is a mixed economy, but in 1991 greater importance was given to public sector than private sector. For example, according to industrial policy 1956, means 17 industries were reserved for public sector and 12 industries for private sector. See, next point, regulated development of private sector. Regulated means under the control. Regulated means in a controlled way. See, development of private sector, economic policies prior to 1991 imposed several restrictions. Several restrictions means foundations on private sector. On private sector. Example, under Industrial Act. Under Industrial Act 1948. License was necessary. License was necessary for new industrial. For new industrial to establish. Now, you know that we are talking about means features of economic policy pursued under planning till 1991. Means we are talking about till 1991 or before 1991. Means we are talking about before 1991 or you can say till 1991. See, under Industrial Act 1948. Remember this, Industrial Act means in the year 1948, license was necessary for new industrial to establish. The main reason. See, what was the main reason? Or you can say, what was the reason behind this? What was the reason behind this? The main reason behind was this, not to allow economic power, not to allow economic power in the hands of private sector. In the hands of private sector. It means that, see, regulated development of private sector means regulated development of private sector, or you can say the reason behind this, the reason behind was regulated development of private sector means not to allow economic power in the hands of private sector. So I hope this second point is clear. See, third point, protection from foreign competition. What do you mean by this? Domestic industry was productive. See, what do you mean by industry? What do you mean by industry? So always remember, industry is a group of firms. Now, domestic industry was protected from foreign competition through high import duties and quantitative restrictions on import. It means that import for our country. What do you mean by import? Or you can say, what do you mean by import in respect to our country? See, now import means when we are purchasing. Suppose we are purchasing any type of goods. You can say we are purchasing any type of goods from foreign country. That will be called import. Suppose government will impose high import duties on imported goods. It means that imported goods will become expensive. It means import will decline. That means people of domestic country will purchase goods of domestic industry. I hope all of you have understood. Now you can say like this, when government imposes high import duties on foreign goods, it means foreign goods will become expensive and domestic goods will become cheaper. It means people of domestic country, or you can say people of our country, will purchase more goods of domestic industry and less goods of foreign industry. So I hope all of you have understood this point also. See, next point, focus on import substitution. See, what do you mean by import substitution? Import substitution is a process. Import substitution is a process in which avoiding imports of those goods which should be produced